This is the story of two girls who share a flat in London and the boys next door, Nick and his friend Hector from Argentina. Bridget is interested in Hector, but Hector is very interested in Annie. Annie doesn't know. So, will he get close enough to tell her? Find out in Extra.
Your landlady is on holiday this week, so I am in charge. The same rules apply. No pets, no parties, no visitors, especially boys. Yours, Eunice Mountain. Eunice Mountain? She sounds terrible. Worse than the tarantula.
If that's possible.
Do you think she'll say no shelves?
She can't. They'll look fantastic.
The Timbal shelves in clear, lacquered beach veneer with six casters and a TV bench. Ooh! Now, where shall we begin?
Annie, it's easy. Rule number one. Always read the instructions first.
Well, that will only take a week.
Okay. Let's have a drink before we begin. Milk, Annie?
Yes, please.
I owe you, Nick. Well, no milk. Would you like some sparkling water?
Right.
I owe you, Nick. I owe you, Nick. I owe you, Nick. How dare he? Would you like some cola?
Thanks, Bridget. I was looking for that.
Nick.
Sorry.
Add it to the list. Or ask your flatmate to buy your food.
Huh?
Wow. You didn't know Hector was rich.
No.
I'll speak to you later.
Wow! What are all these boxes?
Our new shelves, Hector.
I can help you build them. Where are the instructions?
Hector, my friend, rule number one. Never read the instructions.
Oh, I see you have a note from our new landlady then.
Mm-hmm. Eunice Mountain.
Eunice Mountain. I bet she's the same size. Hello? It's Eunice Mountain. Who am I? I'm Nick from flat B. Oh, you want flat A? This is? Hello? Yes, this is flat A. Yes, I am Nick from flat B. Yes, I know this isn't my flat.
I want to see you down there, now!
Sorry. Okay. Right away.
Well?
Eunice Mountain wants to see me downstairs now.
Oh, bad luck, man.
Oh, dear.
Ask her if she has any milk, bread, and biscuits.
Ha ha.
Okay, so first open box A and take out shelf number one.
But which is box A?
This is box C.
And I've got box D.
Ah, I've got it. This is shelf number one.
No, Hector, this is shelf number one.
No, this is shelf number one.
Oh, this is a nightmare.
Okay, Annie, read out the instructions.
Put shelf one against the wall. Hector, I think the books will fall off.
So what's Eunice Mountain like?
Well, you know, not bad.
Are you in trouble?
Probably.
I've got it. Put Paul B on the left and Paul A on the right and the shelf on top. Bridget.
Like this, Hector. Have you put up shelves before, Hector?
Many times.
Or do your servants do it for you?
Oh. I'll do it!
No, 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 I'll do it.
Drop! Drop! Ha! I laugh at instructions.
Oh, that was clever.
It's okay. I can straighten it.
Ha ha! Stand back and watch the master at work.
Go.
Hi, I'm Eunice Mountain, your new landlady.
Anyway, guess what I have discovered? Hector's family, the Ramiro family, is one of the richest in Argentina. Can you believe it?
Wow!
The good news is, our landlady has gone on holiday. The bad news is, her cousin, Eunice Mountain, is our temporary landlady. She sounds awful.
Hi.
Hello. I am Bridget. And this is Annie.
Hello.
And this is Hector from Argentina.
Well.
Hello.
Hector.
Hector lives next door with Nick.
I've met Nick already, haven't I?
Nick.
Oh, yes. That's right.
We need to talk about your rent. In private.
Great.
Measure the D. distance between the shelves. Huh. Uh-huh. Annie, hold this, please. Uh-huh, that's it. And this should be it.
Hector, do you think that's correct? These shelves are for mice. Can I speak to you, please, Hector? So, Hector, one of the richest families in Argentina, the Romero family, and... there you are, Hector. So why the secret?
Because I wanted you to like me, not my money.
Oh, Hector, of course I do. Who else knows?
Nick.
I thought so.
But not Annie. Don't tell Annie yet.
Why, Hector?
Because, Brigetta, because...
Yes?
I am in love with Annie.
Nick has entered the building.
Oh!
So where are you going looking like John Travolta?
He has a date with me, haven't you, darling?
Another date?
But that's three times this week.
Four. We've been to dinner, to the theater, to the cinema, and last night, salsa dancing.
Can you salsa?
Woo! I am the salsa queen.
Yeah, with two left feet.
Pardon?
Nothing.
It sounds great.
What is it tonight? Ping pong?
Tonight, it's karaoke.
And I am the karaoke queen. Let's go. Bye.
I love you.
I am the karaoke queen.
I bet she sings like a toad. So, Hector, where were we?
Okay, I think I've got it, Annie.
So loud, you didn't hear me. I thought we'd have a little chat. Rule number two, no underwear on the radiator.
Well, it's dry now. Give it to me. Give it to... Thank you.
Let me repeat the rules. No parties and no visitors. Especially boys from next door. Especially Nick is mine. Get the message?
Yeah, we get the message.
See you later. Oh, by the way,
That shelf is not straight. Bye.
Well, I have never. What does she... Who does she think she is? The landlady's cousin? Oh, I know that. But no Hector and no Nick. How dare she?
How is Eunice? Problems?
She is very nice.
But
she's just not my type.
What do you mean?
Look! Presents. More presents. Flowers. More presents. Chocolate. And her energy. I'm exhausted.
Nick. Ooh, Nick. Cooey, let's go dancing.
Hector, get rid of her.
Get rid of her? How?
Say something.
What shall I say?
Anything. Tell her I'm not well. I've eaten a hedgehog. I've gone to the moon.
Oh, Nick, are you in there?
Go on!
Okay! Oh, hi.
You're not Nick.
No. Nick's hedgehog has gone to the moon.
Pardon?
Nick's hedgehog is not well. Nick is sad.
So, he must come dancing to make him happy.
No! He cannot dance.
Why not?
He stood on the hedgehog without shoes. Very painful.
Oh, very messy.
So he cannot dance.
Oh, that's a pity. Well, never mind.
Yeah, sorry. Bye.
You just have to come instead.
Pardon?
Come on, let's dance.
Yes, Hector is still building the shelves. I don't know why he is so keen to help. Still, I like it.
Do you think that's correct?
And poor Nick, he looks exhausted. He's going out with Eunice. They've been to the theatre, the cinema, a restaurant, a salsa club, and a karaoke club. She is the karaoke queen!
Go!
I don't think Bridget likes her.
And tighten the screws. Annie, you are a genius. Hi, Hector.
Hi, Annie.
Oh, what's the matter? Oh. Are you okay?
I am exhausted.
What happened?
Last night, Eunice and I...
Yes?
She made me...
Yes?
Go dancing.
Oh.
Annie, she dances like a rhinoceros. Whoa! Annie, the shelves, you finished them.
Oh, just a bit more measuring.
I will help you.
Sorry.
Sorry.
It's okay. It happens when people work together. So, where were we? For the final shelf, take... Oh, Hector!
Oh. Help! Hide me!
Ooh. Eunice?
Eunice! Oh, Bridget, save me!
Why?
It's Eunice!
Nick! Cooey! Oh, Nick!
Oh, there she is! She's too much!
I know you're in there, Nick. Bridget, Annie, I said no boys.
Shall I get rid of her, Nick?
Oh, yes, please. But how?
I'll think of something. Annie, let Miss Mountain in.
Ah, there you are, Nick. And Hector. Bridget, I thought I said no boys.
Oh, yes, you did.
Especially boys from next door.
Yes, yes, you did.
Especially
Nick. He's mine.
Oh, oh Nick. Just wait until I tell my cousin. Oh, by the way, Hector, I've got a fax for you.
Oh, oh, please, give it to me.
It's from your father. It says, coming to London to meet the Prime Minister. My jet arrives at midday. We'll phone father. Oh. Actually, Hector, I think you're more my type.
I don't think so, Eunice.
Oh. Goodbye.
Oh, and don't slam the door. So, Hector, father is flying to London in his private jet to meet the Prime Minister.
Well, they are one of the richest families in Argentina.
So, Bridget, where were we?
Oh, no, Nick!
Huh?
Well, the trick worked. Eunice has gone.
Annie, I will buy you a million shelves.
Oh, well... We better start measuring for them then.
Next time in Extra, Nick dresses up. Bridget is working hard in television, and Hector goes for an audition. Extra, don't miss it.